lights out and we are go. Lopez then starting from pole position, gets a superb launch. Look at Lopez charging towards that first corner. Iaguirre already fast away too far. Team Asia, he's got through on Dixon. Looks like Fermín Aldeguer, who started fourth, has stayed in fourth place. Chantra has made a good start as well. He's gone from seventh to fifth place, trying to find out where Arbolino, he's coming through quick as well.
He's just behind his teammate Sam Lowes, I think. The two off-mile VDS riders are in eighth and ninth. They're behind Pedro Acosta. Acosta lost a place off the line, and Arbolino did not make his usual progress.
Over the line we go. He was close to track limits there, wasn't he? Coming out the chicane was Aldeguer. So too was Kinnett, who's trying to find a way through. All right, here we go then. Aguirre. Dixon's gone through on Aguirre into the first corner. So Dixon now sensing that Acosta is coming. He's probably been getting the pit board about the 37's hot streak. And Dixon for the first time finds himself up in the P2. What can he do now? About a near 3 tenths gap to Lopez at the front. Oh, Acosta was wide there. It looked like he might have actually tucked the front going into turn number five. Gathers it all back up, but that's going to cost him a bit of time. Once again, that is now lap number 11, and at the moment Alonso Lopez has led the lot and he's still resisting in the braking zone into the first corner. That's where Dixon has been really, really strong. This has been one of the best Moto2 battles we've had of the season so far, haven't we? It's been so much the Acosta and Arbolino show, but coming to the fore here in Assen, it's Lopez and Dixon, and here comes Acosta squeezing on the inside. That's got to be inch perfect, millimeter perfect. Aguirre though just snaps the inside line back through turn number five. They almost rub front tyre and rear tyre on the exit of the Struben. They've got to be careful because if they start to sort of trade blows here, this will give Lopez and Dixon a bit of breathing space.
Well, that's a battle I've been waiting to see right from the start of the year before Iaguirre's injury. Aguirre versus Acosta, who could both potentially be in MotoGP next season. And Iaguirre fighting for all he's worth to hold on to that third place. Yet again, Aaron Kinnett was a good chunk quicker in that group in the background. Kinnett once again a 37-0. He took another third of a second off the leaders.
Not a given here that Arbolino is going to hang on to that sixth place, because Aldeguer, having done that long lap penalty, was a lot, he's potentially going to be a lot quicker on this last lap. He's already started to eat away into that deficit back to Arbolino. So then over the line at this start of lap 12, there were less than 3 tenths of a second covering the top four men. This has been, without question, the best Moto2 battle we've had so far. Now that Aldeguer's got a track limits warning, how much more can he contend with? He's getting more dashboard messaging. He's had points in the last few races. Here comes Aguirre then, trying to find a way through on Dixon, while at the same time he's trying to attack Dixon while defend against Acosta here.
Sergio Garcia, he'll be glad to see the back of Assen, won't he? That's his third long lap penalty. Dixon this time does go through. He got the run out of the final chicane. Dixon cleanly through before they hit the brakes for Harbok. Can he stay ahead as they now tip it into turn two? He can. So Dixon now does finally hit the front. Joe Roberts, by the way, didn't crash on that last lap. He clearly had a run on, because he did come through that lap in 22nd place.
Dixon's wide. Dixon's made a big mistake. Sorry, Lewis. Jake Dixon has fluffed his lines there. Just he was trying to make a decisive break. Well, we've seen Arbolino, we've seen Acosta make big mistakes and pay for it in turn five. Well, this time around, it was Jake Dixon. He got in really, really hot. He was leading comfortably by nearly 3 tenths through the first sector. And now he's relegated back to third. It's Aguirre that leads here in Assen. Let's have a look at this one then from the helicopter shot. He banks it left. In he goes. Just runs in a little bit hot there, doesn't he?
Yeah, had to pick it up there to avoid anything else going wrong into the Struben. So Dixon's got all that hard work to do again. He's just got to calm himself here. He knows he's got the pace to get to the front of this race. One thing Jake Dixon hasn't had to do so far in this Grand Prix is overtake Pedro Acosta, which is now what he's got to do. Acosta knows if he can get past Iaguirre here to take the lead in this race, the World Championship lead is waiting for him.
Yeah, the mess up from Dixon saw the eyes light up, didn't they, for Acosta and Aguirre, because they both knew they would have studied the lap-by-lap analysis and seen how strong Dixon has been this weekend. Acosta! I thought he was down. I can't believe how did Pedro Acosta, defying gravity there on the brakes, tipping it left right into Timo Chicane. I thought he was down. I was just about to say Acosta has crashed. Somehow, cat-like reflexes, he picks it up. Kinnett does find a way through then finally into fourth place from the fast-fading Alonso Lopez. You just wonder, with some of these mistakes coming now from Dixon and Acosta, whether the hottest condition of the weekend. Look at this. Oh. Wow. That front tyre there was almost, I mean, ploughing a trough, wasn't it, into that. Look at this. I was just about to shout, Acosta has gone down. He somehow kept it upright, and he continues to remain in this battle for the podium here in Assen. Pedro Acosta then, great spot, Lewis. He didn't lose enough time when he went, when he saved that front end crash going into Timber Chicane. He has a long lap penalty, which then of course brings Alonso Lopez and Aaron Kinnett into podium contention. Fermín Aldeguer as well, who's coming on really strong. He's just taken his teammate Lopez. What more drama can we cope with here in this Moto2 race? He did not lose the 1 second he needed to in that final sector, just as Lewis called it. And Pedro Acosta here, he may well just have enough of an advantage. It'll be really, really close to come back out ahead of Aaron Kinnett. Acosta has quickly got the message there. He just spotted it on his dash.
Oh, he's cut it.
The signal. Did he cut? Well, he almost went down there. It looks like he's cut it and nearly crashed as well.
His front wheel's on the green.
Inside. Pedro Acosta then desperate to come back in front of Kinnett, which
now
he does do.
Nope.
There might be another long lap coming in here.
Arbolino doing his level best to limit the damage to his championship lead. He's just gone through on the fast-fading Alonso Lopez. We saw Dixon earlier go past Ayagura into the first corner. He's doing it again.
They almost touched it. Ayagura's going to go wide. Ayagura's going to go off the circuit. Nothing he can do about that. Aldeguer tried to find a way through on Acosta. So Acosta, at the moment, well within his rights and perfectly able to do so, to try and hang on to this hard-earned podium, vital World Championship points to take for him. Aldeguer gets him on the inside, though. That's a brilliant move by Aldeguer. Podium place beckons for him.
First time in his career that would be a podium, although Acosta's coming back through now on the Vinge Lane. Acosta will have that inside line and into the Rushkanuk. Acosta regains third place. It's come up on our timing screens. Pedro Acosta, long lap penalty completed. He's in the clear.
It is going to be through the Timber Chicane for the final time. Pure and utter Dutch delight for Dixon as he takes his career first victory in the Moto2 World Championship. There is your race winner. He punches the tank, he punches the screen. Absolute delirium for Dixon as he's a first-time Grand Prix winner. Ayagura does take a superb second place after all of his injury problems this season. A great job by Ayagura. Acosta does hold on for the final place in the podium. Kinnett fifth, Lopez sixth. Lopez got Arbolino on the last lap for that sixth place finish. But Jake Dixon in dreamland here. Absolutely awesome job by him.
And this is a moment that Jake Dixon will savour for a long, long time. The tears of victory. A long-awaited moment for Jake Dixon. He is a Grand Prix winner.